Hey, everybody, it's Isaac from Powered by Rock here. I'm sitting here with Rick Lemperes from NeverAnother, which is a Vancouver hard rock band. I call it a hard rock band. I don't know if you describe it as that, Rick, but we'll kind of get into it a little bit more. You guys have been making some pretty rocking music for about 10 years now, since 2010 when you started the band. And I'm going to kind of just ask you, you know, what's the journey been like creating this band? Because you were in other bands, obviously, before, and I assume that you've been a hard rock and metal fan for a decent amount of time, and you guys' sound is pretty cool. So kind of give me the journey of what that's been like over the last 10 years and what happened to kind of make this thing come to life.
All right. Well, I just figured it's time to start up a band again. Back in it's about 2010. I've been going through the music scene since about 1982.
Okay. But, well, that makes me feel young because I was born in 1981 and I'm 40. So I'm like, that's a long time, Rick. It's a long time.
Yeah, I know. Thanks. Let me just calm the dinosaur down there. Anyway, yeah, though, it's been a great ride, really. We started out, we kind of threw something together, just a 5-song EP, just to get something out and into the ears of certain people. It went really well for something being slapped so quickly. Mm-hmm. And we just kept on going. I've been through a couple different bandmates, teammates.
Lineup changes and such.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And the crew I have right now, we're a 4-man. We're all born in 67, so it's kind of cool. Kind of a bunch of old guys doing what we still love.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're pretty heavy. We're heavy rock.
Yeah. Yeah, and I've listened to some of the music. I mean, it's kind of, I mean, it's in the same vein as like a Metallica, but it's got elements of like other things, like a little bit of Tool in there and some more like the more technical elements, which I kind of liked. And, you know, when I just hear like thumping metal, I'm kind of turned off after a few songs. But with yours, it kind of experiments in a little bit every, you know, in almost every song, something slightly different, which is what I found pretty interesting about you guys' music. And that's why I wanted to talk to you today. So kind of explain how you guys make the music and what kind of goes into that.
Well, my brain is kind of corrupt, so I write all the music and it kind of comes out on paper. I introduce to the guys and this is what we have. We're currently recording our fourth studio project right now, which is coming along really nicely. So we do try and keep it versatile, though. I try and keep the music, you know, from acoustic all the way up to yelling at people.
Yeah.
But it has to make sense at the same time.
Yeah, exactly. And that's one thing I noticed about your lyrics. And, you know, I'm glad that you brought up the fourth album because we'll talk about that in a second. But the lyrics, actually, you can kind of follow along where most time in metal, it's just yelling and it's so much like grunting noise. You can't actually tell what's happening in the song. So it's nice to actually be able to follow kind of a little bit of a, you know, the pathway of the song or the journey of what's happening in the story. So I did like that about that as well. So what can people actually expect from the fourth album? What's different about this one and what's kind of the same?
The production is going to be pretty darn good this time around as well. We've got a good team working in the production end of things. The engineer, Ryan Tobias, he's really good with the board. Mm-hmm. And we've got a good mastering company helping us out as well. So, and the music is very versatile. We've got everything from congas to acoustics right on up to some very heavy stuff.
Nice. Very cool. Now, I know you guys have a show coming up at the Roxy on February, I think it's 10th from what I got. It's either the 4th or the 10th. I think I saw two different dates, but I think it's the 10th because I went to the site to purchase the tickets to see if that was the correct date. But that's obviously in Vancouver, BC, so you're up in Canada. What's something you might say about your live shows and what can people kind of expect to see when you guys are up there on stage performing?
Well, we keep it pretty energetic. We don't really hold still for very long. And just pounding out the music that we love and everybody's head starts banging. So it's a good sign.
Come ready to have some beers and have some fun, I suppose, huh?
Oh, yes, please. But
yeah, two drink minimum.
Yeah, please drive careful. Don't drive if you drink.
Yeah, yeah. Awesome.
Or drink if you don't drive.
Yeah. Now you guys, go ahead.
Yeah, no, we got another, we're doing a cancer fundraiser at the end of February as well, out in the good little part of Vancouver, actually the outskirts. And we got the studio working out pretty good right now. It's taken up a lot of our time.
Nice.
Yeah.
So you guys are probably obviously rehearsing for the album, but also rehearsing for the shows. Is that, does that change things of how you go into it? Because are you now throwing some of the new songs into your live sets, or is it like only the new songs, or how does that kind of work? Because obviously everybody's got their, hey, you know, I know you guys for one song or another, or this is my favorite song, and if you don't play it, I'm going to hate you guys forever for not playing it when I was there at that show, right? So what kind of goes into your guys' set list, and how's that working between the album and the live show right now?
Well, as time goes on, too, we do like to keep things interesting.
Yeah.
So we do add the new stuff to the set list as we progress in it and we feel comfortable enough to present it. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
You still keeping the sing-along stuff in there, though?
Yes, we will always keep our good old songs in the set list. There's a couple that kind of fall off the back path there, but we do drag them in when the certain crowd really likes a few songs. So.
Gotcha. Yeah. So if they start chanting for a song, you'd be like, all right, we'll throw it in here. As long as you practice it enough, be like, oh, come on, guys, we haven't played that song in 6 years, but whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, even longer than that with some of them, but
yeah,
you know, we'll try our best to make everybody happy, but good luck with that one, huh?
Yeah. And I have seen a couple of like the live videos from some of the stuff that you guys have posted online. And it seems like you guys have a lot of fun and a good crowd. I mean, you don't see like, you know, just all biker dudes in there just punching and moshing and stuff like that. It looks like a pretty mixed crowd of, you know, pretty respectable and responsible adults, metal loving adults though. So kind of talk to me about your fan base and how that's kind of led you guys to where you are and how that keeps you going.
Well, you know, we kind of have a lot of that 80s blood in us, you know, late 80s, early 90s, heavy metal stuff.
Yeah.
That kind of is the music that everybody really liked and still does want to hear, in, you know, in a lot of aspects.
Yeah.
And that's just kind of what we want to keep doing.
Nice.
Keep rocking it that way, and it's just a perfect fit for Never Another.
Nice. So why did you come up with the band name of Never Another anyway? I didn't actually see that anywhere on there, but kind of explain to where the band name came from.
Oh, I just kind of came up with a whole bunch of them, but I had to narrow it down to a few.
This it's like one band name roulette, like.
Kind of, yeah, exactly. The Wheel of Fortune thing there. But, you know, really, it has a few meanings. You can look at it from different angles. You know, there's never another opportunity to do certain things. There's all kinds. There's never another person like you.
Yeah.
So it's just a perfect fit again.
Yeah, I did see some of that inspirational messaging on the website, which I thought was pretty cool because, you know, especially when you get into like hard rock, people kind of take, I wouldn't say take life and positivity for granted, but positivity is not necessarily like goes hand in hand with metal and hard rock music and every band's aspects. But I like that about you guys' kind of uplifting message and positivity and stuff like that. So that's another very commendable thing. And again, like I said, if you guys were kind of like, hey, we're all out here, you know, Satan worshipers or whatever, and all we care about is everyone, chaos and anarchy, I might not have had you on. I don't know. Like, it'd be an interesting conversation, but it's a lot more fun to have people actually spread positivity through the world.
That's a much better way to go. We got to lift people up.
Yeah, exactly.
Definitely. Cool. Yeah.
So this is going to be kind of a interesting question because, like I said, you know, I emailed you guys' management at one time and said, you know, metal's not exactly my go-to genre. It's not like something that I normally stick to. But I do get into bands, like certain bands that will connect to on different genres. What would you say to someone who might shy away from your music just because of a label like metal or hard rock and, you know, just say, hey, you know, listen to it or whatever. What would you say to them?
Well, I would say you have to give it a shot. Listen to the message. Listen to the skill within the music.
Yeah.
We've all been playing. I've been playing since 1975, so there's a lot of love and time and effort put into it. And give it, you know, give the vocals a chance too. Have a listen to the storyline.
Yeah, cool.
We're not we're not there to really scare too many people.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you know, there are some people, and again, this is just how the genre is, like metal, hard rock, that literally go out and like costumes and, you know, literally it's like their whole thing is like, we're supposed to be scary or something. And it's like, what's the point? Like, we're all adults. Like, I'm 40 years old. I don't need to go to a Halloween costume or a Halloween party every time I want to watch a band. Like, just play.
Yeah, well, we do like to have Halloween parties. We do like to have, but yeah.
But it's not every time out, right? It's not like you have to feel like that's the thing.
No, not at all. It's sure. We just do what we love every time. We enjoy getting up there. It's therapy for us.
For sure, yeah. Now, obviously, you had mentioned, and we've talked about this kind of as we've been speaking, but the band is full of rock veterans with tons of playing experience, and you just said you've been playing since 1975. So how does that experience help create the music and the experience you want to achieve, and how does it kind of make songwriting and just the way you guys come together as a band, you know, is it more professional now? Is it easier to make songs? Is it like you can set time and you can actually get stuff done? You know, because when I was in high school, I was in a band. I've been in a couple bands since, but it's always a chaotic thing trying to keep, you know, everybody always says the term herding cats, and it's always chaotic trying to keep everybody in line. Like, hey, we got band practice. You good? No, I got a thing, blah, blah, blah. I was like, why can't you just come? Like, why can't you just show up? But I assume with kind of a rock veteran experience, like, you guys are probably a bit more ready to be there on time, and it's not something like a, you know, a high school band.
That's correct. Yeah, we do take it serious doing what we love.
Yeah.
But we're having fun doing it as well.
Yeah.
That's really important to us. I mean, we're old enough to be smart about it. But honestly, yeah, I don't know. As far as the long term, we've been at it for a long time. And writing music, I've been writing songs since late 70s, early 80s. So over time, you just kind of find your groove, and you feel, you grow with it.
Yeah.
You get better at everything you do, more practice, more time you spend. Oh, there's my dog.
That's all right. He's trying to get his cameo in there. So when you actually bring the songs to the rest of the band, is it kind of like a quick turnaround of like actually getting the music put out there and putting a song together?
No, it takes some time. I'm pretty picky about it, not to be a jerk about it, but I do want it. I do know what I want to hear.
Yeah.
And the drummer being the original guy with me, he and I have quite the chemistry.
Yeah.
It just kind of falls into place every time we get together. Our new bass player is awesome as well. And we got Sean. He's the newest member. It does get chaotic at times introducing new riffs and stuff and putting songs together because they're so intricate.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's just kind of other people trying to get inside of my head. It's pretty difficult.
Yeah. It's like it's like a painter trying to explain what he sees. And, you know, until he actually paints it out, then nobody knows what the hell he's talking about, right?
Right. It takes time to put a good song together.
Well, that's good. Yeah, it's good perspective because, you know, some bands are just like, we get it. We're all like in sync. And, you know, some like obviously with lineup changes, it does make it more difficult over time. But at least, you know, the process is there and you work through it and make it happen because that's the most important thing is getting the end result, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Show must go on.
Yeah, exactly. So, just out of curiosity, what do you find is like, what's the ultimate goal for NeverAnother? Are you looking to do like actual long distance touring? Are you trying to get more listeners and play regional shows, or what kind of elements of like traveling or, you know, kind of success are you looking to achieve? Obviously everybody wants world fame, but what does that look like if like 3 to 5 years from now, you guys are like really doing well? What do you think you guys are up to?
Well, we'll go wherever they take us. Yeah. If they allow us. No, we love going out. We'll tour everywhere. I have toured through, you know, late 80s, kind of 90s. But I'd like to do it with this new group of guys. We have a good product to show and tell, and I think it would be fun. But, you know, we'll keep writing. We'll keep playing our shows. And if all goes well, we'll see you soon.
Nice. Yeah. Well, I'm in Vegas, so you guys would fit right in here. There's tons of 80s and 90s acts that, you know, play that kind of genre of music. So If you guys make it down here, I'll definitely show up.
Okay. Excellent. We'll hit you up for a couch.
Yeah. Perfect. All right. So I got some rapid fire questions here just to get some quick hits on some of the things that might be people might want to know about you and your band. But first question is, what bands influence your music specifically for Never Another?
Okay. I'm going to throw out Megadeth.
Okay.
Godsmack. And some good old Metallica, I guess, is in there.
Nice.
Yeah. But there's other stuff too.
Yeah. Like I said, there's elements of little things here and there that other bands I think probably throw in there. But yeah, I mean, Metallica, Megadeth, I mean, those guys go hand in hand. Godsmack, that's another good one right there. And that's cool. So yeah. Other than your own music, what was the last album, the last full album you listened to?
The last full Testament, the latest, Testament put out a new one now, but this one's from 2018 or so.
Okay.
Great stuff.
Did you just recently pick it up, or like, have you heard it and you just recently listened to it again?
I picked it up.
Okay.
At a CD store. It was nice. Just rare. Had to do it.
Awesome.
But yeah. I love Testament. They were great back in the 80s, yeah. But they're better now.
Nice.
A lot more talent.
Very cool. What bands would you like to tour with if you got the chance?
Well, anyone. Megadeth, yeah. Metallica,
Queensryche, yeah.
Sabotage. I like a bunch of those guys. Whoever wants us on tour, we're there.
Nice. Very cool. Yeah. If you could play with any musician, alive or dead, who would it be?
Oh, well, I've been on stage with Dimebag Darrell back in 94.
Nice. Very cool.
And yeah, that was quite the experience.
Were you playing with him, or how did that come about?
We were on stage in Seattle. Yeah, we were doing a show down there.
Nice.
But,
and for any of our listeners who might not know, Dimebag Darrell, former guitar player from Pantera, I believe, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Pantera.
Yeah. I'm like,
incredible.
Pantera. Yeah. Yeah. Incredible. Unfortunately, not with us anymore, but yeah, he was a fantastic guitar player.
That's correct. Too bad. He was very influential. Yeah. Okay. Where were we?
Alive or dead? Who would you want to play with?
Alive or dead? Oh, Cal. Chris Oliva.
Okay.
From Sabotage.
Okay. Interesting. And then off the top of your head, what would you say is one of the best albums of all time?
Kiss Alive 1.
Okay. Did you say Kiss Live 1?
Kiss Alive 1. Yeah.
Okay.
1975.
Okay.
That was one of my favorites.
Nice.
That and Cooper, Billion Dollar Babies.
Nice. Yeah. Those guys, you're talking about anthemic songs and just rocking positivity when they play. They don't get that image. Their image may be a little different, especially Alice Cooper, but they're all about having fun and being, you know, all about positivity. I mean, Alice Cooper's radio show, love listening to that thing. I mean, he still DJs. I think he's still doing it anyway, but yeah, he did that for years.
I hope so.
Very cool. So I feel like people have got a pretty good idea of what Never Another is about, got a little bit more into your head, Rick. Do you have anything you want to say before we head off and kind of end this interview for today?
Well, I'd just like to say to everyone, stay tuned. We got a wicked album coming right on up. And if you call for it enough, we'll be in your town soon too.
Nice. And we'll put some links to your music and everything below the video and everything. So.
Very cool. Thank you.
Nice. Guys, yeah, go make sure to check out the links on the to the YouTube, Facebook, website, Spotify, everything that they got. And then, everything else that Never Another has coming up. It's going to be awesome. And I thank you, Rick, for coming on and having this interview today. And I look forward to seeing what comes out of the fourth album and what's going on with Never Another in the month of February.
Much appreciated, Isaac. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Thanks for coming. Yeah.